Welcome back to this portrait painting series, and I'm quite happy about something, which is actually a problem in the painting, but it will give us a chance to talk about this even more. I know I've mentioned it before, but when the paint dries, it sinks in, particularly when you use these darker pigments, and they dry more matte than they appeared when you were first painting it and when the paint was wet. And so we can really see this edge right here on her eye. This whole cheek is more dull than it was. The edge of this cast shadow, you can see the difference there. There's more oil in the paint up here and then less down there on the perimeter. That changes the values. I assume you can see it on the video. If you can't, it's very evident in real life here that these values have changed. And I don't feel confident enough in the paint being dry to oil out or to put any kind of mineral spirits or refined linseed oil over that dry paint to make it look glossy. It's reasonably dry to the touch, but it's only been a day. I painted this yesterday, these cheeks, and I feel like if I took that risk and I put oil on it, that I could lift off paint from the previous day, and I don't want to do that. So what I'm going to do is probably the most important lesson I could possibly teach is I'm going to live with it looking weird for a little while. I think it at least needs another day. I'm up against the weekend, so I know that after today, I probably won't paint on this again till Monday. So that's several days. By that point, I'll be confident enough to oil that out. And the good news is that that's the second half of this video. So let's bear with it, and let's go ahead and jump into that mouth, do the underpainting of the upper lip, the lower lip, and the lower orbicularis oris so we can get that whole mouth form down, let it dry, come back for the second half of the video, and paint that opaque form. As I go up here and touch that flesh tone, it's blending in. It's too much the same value. You almost can't see it. And when you look at the reference of her, there's clearly contrast. So I think I went too far in terms of lightening it. So I'm going to go back and darken a little bit with that umber. Let's see if we can get that immediate relationship more correct between the flesh above and that lip. That looks more appropriate there. All right, now we're really gonna go for some of those darker values, that ivory black, raw umber, alizarin, because we're gonna wrap around to that shadow side of the mouth here. And I'm not going quite as dark as I could, because again, I wanna be able to have some separation, some contrast between that form shadow on the upper lip and the cast shadow on the lower lip, which I will make darker. It'll be the darker of the two because it's not facing as much reflected light. So let's go ahead and do that now. Let's grab that raw umber, a little bit of alizarin to give it that chroma in there, just a little touch of it. And it's really about shaping here. You gotta think three-dimensionally, and you gotta kind of stay true to the drawing here because you're shaping the edge of the upper lip, and it's conveying the shape of the overall upper lip as it's casting a shadow. And then it's also conveying the shape of the lower lip and how that distorts and warps the shape of that cast shadow. So it's a lot of things, a lot of pressure. Get it right. No, I'm kidding. It's okay, but just, as long as you think about that, as you think about what you're painting, you stand a much better chance. My lower lip, oh man, I drew that sort of bad. That lower lip looks short. Why am I so bad at drawing? I don't know. I gotta make room for it somehow. I'll probably push, I don't know what I'm gonna do. I could either push up or down or a little bit of both. I'm kind of pushing up on that cast shadow to make it a little taller. I think I did get a little thick on it up on this side particularly. So I'll do that. And then I'll push over the edge at the bottom. So I'm just kind of dropping my paper towel. I'm pushing the color down over the line of the lower lip and then up over that cast shadow a little bit. So I'm kind of buying a little bit of space there without radically moving anything. It already looks better to me. So let's just sort of sit with that, see how we feel. Okay, so the final thing we're gonna do here in this session before we let it dry is paint the two sides of the lower orbicularis oris. This is an overall round form. Let's imagine coming down around from here, and this is less light facing, so it's gotta turn down and be darker than up here. Now, I was tempted to go back in and add some of those highlights on that lower lip here before we finish, but let's leave it like this. Let it dry in a very consistent, even, compressed way. And come back to it. All right, I'm gonna let that dry and I'll be back in just 1 second your time so we can keep painting on a dry surface. okay, I'm back, this is dry, it's been about 2 days my time, so things have really sunken in now, and you can see that there's a real matte finish up there, which was there before, here on that cast shadow again. This is very dull now, and of course the mouth where we painted last time, earlier in the video, is dull as well. So this time, I'm gonna go ahead and oil out. Things are really dry now. This has been many days, this has been 2 days, this has been many days as well, so I feel safe to oil out. So let's go ahead and make that a part of this video. I'm gonna grab a number 6 synthetic tackling round. It's clean, and I'm gonna get a little bit of solvent on it. Just a little bit of solvent on the end to make it wet. And then I'm gonna grab a little bit of refined linseed oil. I'm using Winsor Newton brand. The solvent is Gamsol, and the refined linseed oil is Winsor Newton. So I have a little bit of that on the brush, and I'm going to brush it over some of these matte areas. Let's go ahead and do it right here. So that's a little bit of solvent on the brush and then refined linseed oil. And I'm erring on the side of not using very much. You don't want to keep oiling out and make your whole painting turn yellow in 6 months. So you err on the side of using very little. Anytime you have questions about this overall orbicularis oris muzzle form, imagine the lips not being there and just sort of see this as a mound. I know that's kind of strange. You can think Keanu Reeves in The Matrix when he loses his lips there in the first one. This sort of very generalized form, the light coming in here and it rolls around in this direction, almost like part of a sphere. If you're heading into an area you've already painted and you notice that what you're putting down doesn't match, pause and say, okay, I'm trying to meet this area that I've already painted, and everything I'm putting down now is too light, or it's too yellow, or too dark, whatever the case might be. And you sort of feel like, if I just keep going with this, I'm gonna herald in a whole new value range, whole new color range, and have to repaint everything. And I don't wanna do that. I don't think that is necessary here. I like the new part I'm painting. I like the previous part. I wanna make them kind of connect together without having to repaint the whole thing. Then stop, look at the area that you're trying to paint up to and connect to. Take a moment and do what we always do, mix and match that color that's down there. What I just did was that gradation there around the corner of the mouth. I liked it. So I paused and I mixed and matched that color. So I said, okay, now I have that on the palette again. And now I can kind of work that mixture of the previous color with the new colors I have wet into wet on the palette so that they're integrated together and they flow. So again, I don't just suddenly bulldoze everything I've previously painted and have to repaint everything. The sphere-like form here. It's the sort of node at the corner of the mouth where the zygomatic is major, minor, kind of grab onto, what pulls your mouth up into a smile. Think about as a sphere-like form. Really kind of isolate it in your mind as a goal and say, I'm gonna make this look round. It's a narrow value range. You don't want it to protrude out. You want it to feel a part of the greater form. But still, give it that moment where you really think about it, sculpt it, and then you can go back in and even it back out if it is too exaggerated. But it needs, and every form needs special attention and nurturing. Now, just above the highlights is where there's a really nice chromatic area of the red of the lips. I don't want to make it too big, but I'm grabbing some alizarin. I have some orange in there. I'm going right up along that cast shadow, which is going to stay relatively crisp because the casting form, the upper lip, is right there, right by it. Let me grab a little bit more alizarin. Right there before that shadow. Now I'm cutting into the shadow a little too much, so I'm gonna have to grab that shadow value, which is very close to being black out of the tube. This probably won't be evident on camera, but I'm very subtly pushing that shadow back down. All right, now let's go ahead and put in that highlight. Let's grab some white there. I don't want it to be too strong, so I'm kind of rubbing some of it into this color that I already have. And let's go ahead and we'll start cautiously. We'll start with almost the outer perimeter of the highlight, and let's really follow, stay on the form, but follow that pattern that you visually see. So you have kind of a little highlight right there that kind of angles like that. Then you have one that goes up like this. Then it kind of levels out before the midline. Then you hop over the midline. Now, as I do this, I got to be mindful of the highlights that I painted elsewhere, which I'd never pop them as bright as they might be in the reference because I wanted a more compressed, unified sort of value range. So I got to make sure that I don't pop this too light, but I do see that there's a little bit more range or room to expand my range there. And that looks pretty good. And I'm putting a little bit of extra value up here. Now that I see this range here, I realize I have a little room to be able to make that upper lip a little bit more round and curved. Looking at that midline here on that tubercle, and so to the right, our right of that midline, I can bend it a little bit more towards the light, but I'm careful not to bend too much of it on the left-hand side of that midline because I want to retain that sphere-like roundness. All right, I'm going to leave that there for now. We have a lot ahead of us. We have to paint the rest of the face and then do revisions. So we'll take it as it comes and work through it together. Thank you so much for watching. If you like my content, make sure you hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, do people ring the bell anymore? If you do, ring it, and that way you can follow the rest of this series. Thanks for watching, and I will see you soon.